$275 million engineering marvel went down in history for its unique construction process and its ability to shorten the distance between the Pacific and Atlantic Oceans. So today, I'll be talking to you about how the Panama Canal works. Thanks. So a brief history of the canal. Ever since the beginning of overseas shipping, businessmen have been looking for a way to shorten the distance between the Atlantic and Pacific Oceans, and that's when inspiration struck to build the canal through Panama. Great Britain businessmen were the first to attempt to build the canal, but the construction never went past the planning period. After that, the French also attempted, and they started construction, but due to widespread illness throughout the workers and the project causing the French to go bankrupt, the project inevitably failed. It wasn't until President Theodore Roosevelt caught wind of the idea that success actually began. So there was some difficulty at first securing the land, but in 1903, the Hay-Bunau-Varilla Treaty was created, which gave the United States a 10-mile wide strip of land, a one-time $10 million payment to Panama, and an annual $250,000 payment to Panama. The U.S. also guaranteed guaranteed Panama its own independence in order to secure this land. The construction process of the canal started in 1903 and ended in 1914, which took a total of 11 years to build. And once it was finished, it symbolized the U.S.'s technological and economic power. And in 1977, President Jimmy Carter signed official documents giving the canal back to Panama. The construction picture. So how the canal was made, it was discovered, well, the Isthmus of Panama, which is where the canal is, was discovered by Vasco Nunez, and once that was discovered, that's where Theodore Roosevelt decided to put the canal. Once he was gained the land to create the canal, his head engineer, George Washington Goethals, split the construction process into three main divisions, the Atlantic, Central, Pacific. Once it was split into three divisions, excavation began, and by 1907, 1 million cubic yards of land were being excavated monthly, and once the land was excavated, the four dams had to be created in order to build the Gayton and Miraflores lakes within the canal. After that, there was 12 locks that had to be put in, 6 per lane. There were 3 Gayton locks, 2 Miraflores locks, and 1 Pedro Miguel lock. The locks are all concrete, and they are 33.53 meters wide, 320 meters long, and 13 to 3 meters thick from the bottom to the top. And here's the locks, well, yeah, the locks, like, lock and so forth. So how the canal itself actually works is a relatively simple process. So the ship enters through the Atlantic Ocean, and it goes through the first of the 3 Gayton locks. And from once it enters the first Gayton lock, water is slowly added to the individual lock to raise the ship slowly to the sea level of the next lock. And this process is repeated 2 times until the ship exits through the last of the Gayton locks and enters through the Gayton Lake, which is also connected to the Culebra Cut. And this is the highest sea level of the canal, and it's also the longest at 29 miles long. The canal itself takes 10 hours to ship through. After it exits through the Culebra Cut, it enters through the first, it enters to the Pedro Miguel lock, which is, there's only one. And once it's entered to there, water is released and it lowers the ship to the sea level of the 1.2 mile long Miraflores Lake, where it ships through and then enters the first of the 2 Miraflores locks, where the ship enters, water is released. This process is repeated another time until the ship is at the sea level of the Pacific Ocean. process from an aerial view one more time. And here's how the ship would go up periodically and then sail through. So how the canal affects our lives today, it is still being used. In 2016, it was expanded to add a third lane that was both wider and deeper for larger cargo ships to go through, which this is handy for us since a substantial amount of U.S. shipping goes through the canal. This both makes shipping quicker and products more affordable for us once they get here. Here's the extension. Okay. And so a $375 million engineering marvel that took 11 years to build. Panama Canal is still used today, and thank you for listening.